Do women really need less niacin than men, like the RDA suggests? Or might women need more niacin than men? Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of ChrisMasterjohnPhD.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about women versus men for the niacin requirement. If you look at the RDA for niacin, for an adult male, it is 16 milligrams a day. Technically, it's 16 milligrams of niacin equivalents, which accounts for the fact that you can get niacin from the protein you eat by synthesizing it in your liver, or you can get niacin from food. So the sum total of niacin contributors, 16 milligrams. For females, it is 14 milligrams. It's 2 milligrams less per day. Now that changes in pregnancy and lactation. Pregnancy, it goes up to 18 milligrams, and lactation, it comes down to 17 milligrams, both of which are higher than for males. But for a non-pregnant, non-lactating female, the RDA is 14 milligrams of niacin equivalents compared to 16 milligrams for the male. So I wanted to know why the RDA is higher for men than it is for women, and I read the RDA report. What they did was they presented a table that had four studies on the niacin requirement. Two of them were done in men, and two of them were done in women. The two that were done in women showed the niacin requirement to be higher than the two that were done in men. Then they say in the text, although the data in the table suggests that women need more niacin than men, these are not high quality comparisons of males and females. These are separate studies with separate methodologies, and we don't have a good means of comparing men and women from that table. Therefore, we will assume that because women weigh less and because women have lower energy requirements, that women need less niacin than men. So the data says that women need more, but because the data is not good, we rely on our assumption that has no data behind it, that women need less. On top of this, they discuss the physiology regulating the synthesis of niacin from tryptophan, the amino acid in our diet that serves as a niacin precursor. That tryptophan comes from eating protein. And what that physiology shows is that estrogen causes us to make more niacin from tryptophan. That means that women produce more niacin than men do. And that means that women, under conditions of high estrogen exposure, such as during the peaks of estrogen at two different locations in the menstrual cycle, including around ovulation and in the days leading up to menstruation, are going to make more niacin from tryptophan. Women on birth control pills are going to produce more niacin from tryptophan. Women who are pregnant are going to produce more niacin from tryptophan. And so why might this be the case? Well, no one really knows, but one potential explanation for that is that this is a way to make sure that enough niacin is there to meet the needs associated with the increased energy expenditure that goes into pregnancy and lactation, and also to meet the niacin requirements of what becomes the baby. And you might reason from this that if women have a regulated way to make sure that they get enough niacin for those purposes, that means that women on the whole need more niacin than men. In fact, physiologically, what could better succinctly summarize the difference between women and men, except that women have more estrogen, right? And so if the key defining physiological difference between women and men makes women make more niacin from tryptophan, it seems like women have a greater demand for niacin. That would agree with the data that was used to make the RDA, and that would support, even though that data might not have been high quality, it still makes much more sense to believe that women have a higher niacin requirement than males do. Now, women are probably better at synthesizing niacin from protein. And so you could argue that if women have enough protein in their diet, they don't need as much preformed niacin because women are better at synthesizing niacin from protein. But the RDA doesn't say how much preformed niacin you need given a certain amount of protein. It says, how much protein plus niacin do you need, right? And so the woman who doesn't eat enough protein, which is probably many women, is the woman whose better synthesis of niacin from protein doesn't matter. It doesn't put her at any advantage over the men. She just has a greater need for total inputs of niacin precursors plus niacin. So we should keep this in mind going forward to the next episode about how to get enough niacin from food, that women should be especially concerned with the topic of getting enough niacin, because women probably need more than men. And as we go into the next episode, when we define how much we need, we'll take into account that women probably need a little bit more than men.
This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Living Collagen. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, living collagen, bone marrow, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com.
This episode is brought to you by Vitamins and Minerals 101. This is my new free 30-day course providing one lesson a day on each nutrient delivered straight to your inbox. It can go to your email or it can go to your Facebook Messenger. If you get the Messenger version, it's taught by Chris Masterbot, my baby bot. It's more interactive. There are more emojis and there are more jokes. But both email and Facebook Messenger are incredibly educational. Each lesson covers why the nutrient is important to your health, how to know if you have too little or too much or the wrong balance with other nutrients, how to get it from food, and when you should think about supplementing. It is not a technical or advanced course. It is completely minimum in its technical jargon, and it is designed for the beginner with no background in nutrition and no background beyond high school in the basic sciences. Nevertheless, many people who have backgrounds in nutrition are saying that it is an amazing refresher course full of nuggets of valuable information in each lesson. Sign up completely free by Facebook Messenger or by email at chrismasterjohnphd.com/101. This episode is brought to you by Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet. This is my recipe to empower you to banish any deficiency or nutritional imbalance from your body. I've been through the pain of my teeth falling apart, my stomach being in constant pain, and my OCD going off the rails during my stint with veganism, to the point where panic attacks were the norm and I was afraid to eat any of the food in my house. I've been through the path of healing using nutrient-dense animal foods to nourish all the systems of my body and become a new person. But I've also learned that my needs change over time. The red meat and liver that were so healing in my recovery from veganism later started sapping my energy and brain power, only to find out that I'm genetically predisposed to iron overload and need to manage it with blood donations. And I've learned from friends, colleagues, and clients that everyone is different. Your needs are not mine. Mine aren't what they were 10 years ago. Yours won't be what they are now in 10 years. That's why we need a precise recipe to know exactly what's missing, exactly what's overloaded, exactly what's imbalanced, and an action plan to fix things, and a way to measure our success. That's what I've done with Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet. Get your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet and use the code LITE20, that's L-I-T-E and the number 20, LITE20 to get 20% off. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Master Pass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount. The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.